Namaste students. In the previous class, we have studied income, expenditure account, receipts, payment account. Now, today's class, we will see the detail regarding balance sheet. So, here we have the balance sheet format, where we have balance sheet as on which date it will be given, that date it will be started, and the asset side and liability side, and two amount column we have. So, assets and liability contains the same items like how we have studied in the previous year. Same way it will be there, but here some of the items are extra. Like what you will understand which is assets and you will understand which is liability. Here you need to know last year assets were there, liabilities were there. After writing the liability item, under liability we also had a capital. We also had the item called capital. Under that, we used to write the things from how much capital is there, if the drawing is there, we have or net profit if it is there, we used to add drawing if it is there, minus, and we used to get the capital. But this year, it will not be, especially in case of the non-profit organization, it will not be shown directly a capital. Okay? Capital will not, we will not write the word capital because it is a organization. Organization, we use a capital fund. Okay? How to find capital fund? Capital and capital fund is not same. Capital is used in the profit organization. Capital fund is used in the non-profit organization. Now we have capital in the case of the profit organization. Since it is a non-profit organization, we have to write capital fund. That is capital fund. Okay? Previous class I have told, beginning only I have told what is capital fund. Capital fund is nothing but it is the differences between assets and liability. Okay, capital fund is nothing but it's the differences between assets and liability. Okay, sometimes they will only give capital fund. If it is not given, what will happen? How to find the capital fund? Okay, capital fund also it is similar to the balance sheet because it is there here. It's the differences between assets and liability. So what we have to do is we have to draw assets and liabilities and balance sheet we have to draw. Okay, we have defined all the things related to assets. Okay, assets, for example, building, cash, debtors. All this prepaid expenses, all this we will write, and it might be creditors, bills payable, all this item. But here, see, if it is here around 1 lakh amount is there, okay? If it is here 1 lakh, and here when you add it, it is coming around 80,000. So 1 lakh minus 80,000, what amount you are going to receive, that is 20,000, is considered as a capital fund. Okay, capital fund. Capital fund is calculated on the beginning of the year and not on the end of the year. Okay, capital fund, beginning of the balance sheet, it is calculated, beginning of the year it is calculated and not on the end of the year. So this is how capital fund is calculated. Now we will see the problem related to capital fund. So now we understood what is capital fund. So now let us see the problem related to the capital fund. If it is given, how we are supposed to write? See, from the following ledger balance, as on 1/4/2015, find the opening capital fund. They have asked find the opening capital fund. And we know that the capital fund is calculated based on the assets and liability. Write all the items, whichever items is given under the asset, write it under assets. If the items are given about the liability, write under the liability. And the balancing figure is considered as a, it is considered as a capital fund. So now let us see here. See, I'll start balance sheet. As on 1/4/2015. mention. So bill name is rupees 80,000. Next we have furniture rupees 20,000. Investments, we all know that investment, furniture, all this belongs to the asset. So I am writing under SSSL. Investment rupees 40,000. Next we have outstanding expenses. How to differentiate, what is, how to write, which side it should be written, outstanding expenses or outstanding income. See, here we have the balance sheet where we have this is asset and liability, correct? So here we write some of the asset item and some of the liability item. Along with that, in the asset item contains the outstanding items, correct? So we have to remember this chart. Always outstanding expenses are liability, outstanding expenses are liability, outstanding income are assets. We know that outstanding income, because last year in the financial statement chapter we have come across this word where outstanding expenses are liability, outstanding incomes are assets. Same way prepaid, if it is there, similarly prepaid expenses are considered as an asset to the organization, whereas prepaid or paid in advance, here also prepaid or paid in advance or prepaid, here expenses, so here incomes. Okay, this chart is very important to know which is assets and liability. So when you write, we have to, you know, assume this, and it's not assumption, it's a logic, correct? We have to write it here. So I have already finished writing investment. Outstanding expenses is considered as a liability, so I'll write under outstanding expenses under liability. Outstanding expenses rupees 2000. Okay, next we have outstanding subscription. While studying the word subscription, I have told what is subscription, correct? Subscription is nothing but it is an income for the organization. It is where the subscription fees is received, correct? It is receiving the money, it's an income for the organization. So when outstanding income is there, under asset, correct? Outstanding income. So outstanding subscription is considered as an income. Outstanding subscription amount rupees 1000. Next we have prepaid insurance. Insurance is an expenses for the organization where we are paying, correct? Prepaid, now paid in advance or prepaid in advance. Prepaid insurance is an expenses. It is considered again as a liability. So I'll write under asset. It is considered as an asset. So prepaid expenses is nothing but here it is insurance. Any item, if it is expenses, it is considered as an asset. So rupees 500. Next, subscription received in advance. Subscription received in advance. Advance subscription is an income. Income received in advance is considered as a liability. So subscriptions received in advance. Rupees 3000. Next we have cash in hand and cash in bank. As I told, cash in hand, as we know it, it is always an asset to the company, organization. So I will write cash in hand rupees 3200. Cash at bank rupees 6300. Rupees 6300. So now we can write the total of that. So what is the total? Total 1 lakh 40. So total. So here we have 80,000. 80 plus 20. 1 lakh 40. 1 lakh 40. 41, it is considered as it is full amount is 1,51,000. Here it is 10,000, right? So 1,51,000. 51,000 minus 5,000 is 1,46,000. 1,56,000, correct? Yes. So we have 1,51,000. 1,51,000. This balancing figure is called as Chapter-1. Okay, this balancing figure is called as considered as a Chapter-1. This is a balancing figure. So you can write, put a star, or you can just write the word balancing figure. Okay, now let us see one more illustration.